Whenever you're ready.
Okay. My name is Kevin Kelly. I am manager of battery, hybrid, and electric vehicle communications at GM. But today I'm demonstrating the new IntelliLink infotainment systems here that we have for Buick. It'll be available on the 2012 LaCrosse this fall. And basically what we're trying to do here is provide connectivity that's seamless, easy, and least distracting for the customer to link to their smartphone, their mobile apps, and a number of different solutions that allow them to stay connected to their world. So what we've got here is we've got right here on the screen an 8-inch touchscreen, color screen, that allows us to have access to a number of different solutions. Right now I have my BlackBerry connected to the system through Bluetooth. And if connecting phones by Bluetooth is really easy, just go to the phone button, click on Bluetooth settings, then go to Bluetooth, pair device, and right then it sends a signal out to the phone to saying that it wants to connect to the phone, and you just accept, and it's that simple. So we can then connect devices, including such devices as iPhones, Androids, and BlackBerries to the vehicle wirelessly through Bluetooth. So we have that connectivity. And now whenever you're connected through Bluetooth, we transfer access to your phone book, as well as your music and your Pandora app on your phone that you can access directly through the radio and the infotainment system.
Now, is that address book downloaded actually to the car?
No, it's housed still on your phone.
Okay.
So it's not transferred to the car. We also have a USB jack that we have available to allow customers to use for either tethered connectivity to their phone or for storing of MP3s on a flash drive and bring it right into to the car and have access to it there. The system also has access to grace notes. So what we do is by having that grace notes connectivity and a capability, we can then get the album art for each of the artists, and we can download data such as nicknames and other tags that we can access through the voice recognition to access the music on the USB drive. But right now I'm going to show you a couple of different solutions that we have in terms of innovative connectivity. First one is I'll show you is Pandora. We have Pandora access through the radio, and what happens is once you access it, it goes to your mobile device and activates the mobile application for your Pandora radio. So right now it's playing some of my Pandora music and some of my Pandora radio channels that I selected. And
so you have to have Pandora on your phone,
yes.
Correct? And that's a paid service, right?
This Pandora is actually free.
Free, okay.
So I have that on my phone right now. And so I can do, like you'd expect to be able to do with Pandora if you have the Pandora access, is thumbs up, thumbs down to particular music. I can do it from the screen. I can say thumbs down on this. And what it'll do is then go out there and update my access to Pandora to say don't play that song again. And then it'll then move on to the next song. And again, we're now linked up through the phone to Pandora to keep that system running. So the Pandora access then continues. But if I wanted to say I really like this song, as opposed to pushing on the screen, I can do it this way.
Please say a command.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
A little bit delayed because of the connection here with the rainstorm, but she then sent the thumbs up command to Grace Notes, and now that is updated in my Grace Notes profile on my phone. So the other thing we can do is through voice.
Please say a command.
Tune XM Boneyard.
Tuning to XM Boneyard.
So I have access to any of the XM stations through voice commands. I can also do regular FM or AM.
Please say a command.
Tune FM 96.5.
Tuning to FM 96.5.
So regular FM band, I could do AM band as well. The other thing is, as I mentioned before, we now have access to our phone books, so I can do this.
Please say a command.
Call Carolyn Normandin on cell.
Calling Carolyn Normandin on cell.
So it now goes in and grabs her number from the phone book through that tag and through that voice recognition operation, and now calls her on her cell phone. And you can do that for anybody who's in your phone book.
Carolyn Normandin.
Hi, Carolyn. We're just testing the IntelliLink system for Roosevelt.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. I can't see you.
Thanks.
I'm here.
All right. Thank you, Carolyn. Bye-bye. So that's available, too. And so as I mentioned earlier, too, about the USB and Grace Notes, just show a little bit here about how we can do different things with the Grace Notes system by voice as well.
Please say a command.
Play artist The Stones.
Indexing is currently in progress. Please try again later.
Okay, the system is still indexing data from Grace Notes right now, so we can't get access to that right now, but... If we were completely indexed, I could say play artist The Stones, and it would automatically recognize that the Stones is the nickname for the Rolling Stones, and it would start playing the Rolling Stones. Or I could say play artist The Boss, and it would play Bruce Springsteen, because Bruce Springsteen's got the nickname The Boss that's recognized.
Now, does the system allow you to import a Pandora recording to an SD card on your phone?
It does not. No. Okay. No, not at this point. The other thing that I'll show you is the next thing that we have available that's part of our overall connectivity solutions for not just Buick, but for GM overall, is we have our mobile app, the OnStar MyLink mobile app. And what that does is it gives you some information on your vehicle, such as fuel level, oil life remaining, how much miles of fuel range you have left, and then gives you tire pressure as well. But also what you have access to is using the mobile app for remote access of locking and unlocking the vehicle, remote start, and flashing the lights and sounding the horn. So for instance, if you're somewhere where you're, let's say we're a couple blocks down the road and it was really warm out today and the car was getting, you know, pretty warm in the cabin, you could do the remote start application and it would go ahead and start the vehicle up and cool down the cabin. Then you would walk up to the vehicle, use your key fob to unlock the door, and then put the key in and start the vehicle. So that's our overall package right now of infotainment solutions and the new IntelliLink for Buick.
Now, is there any connectivity to video screens in the rear?
There are video screens available in the rear of the vehicle, but that is not
something
that we have as a part of this system, no.
Okay. Great.
Okay.
Thanks.
All right.